Hey guys, hey, I'm going to Atlanta today. I'm gonna go with my family and I have my suitcase ready. I am so excited. Okay, so I have my outfit there like already in the bag, so I'm not gonna take it out, but and then this is the bag I'm taking. All I'm taking is a power bank with a charger and then my wallet, which is in a little tiny like one of these, you know what I mean? And then that's it, that's all I'm taking. Obviously I'm gonna take my lipstick and my lip liner, I'm gonna take my eye drops, and I'm also gonna be taking like hair ties and stuff like that, but they're like in my current backpack, I mean purse. So I have my jewelry on, it's from Ana Luisa. I have it on. So I got this necklace, these gold earrings, and then this ring. I also have these nails that I did, they're like gel nails, I did them myself, but they're looking really good. And I have, I don't know if you guys can see them, but I have like these glittery press-ons that I want to wear for the concert, but I'm gonna have to remove these, so I don't know if I'm gonna be wearing these. I'll keep you updated. I also got a watch band, it's like black with glitter, for my watch for the concert. Normally I just wear this one. I need to get on the road in the next 30 minutes, so I'm in a little bit of a rush. Also, I saw that she changed, I think, invisible strings for the one. I love the one. I can't believe it. I can't believe it. I'm so excited. It's not that I don't like invisible strings, but obviously I like the one better. I think that today I am gonna try to stop by to see the merch lines and everything like that. If I am there, I'll show you that, but if not, I'll see you tomorrow. Okay guys, so I am at the hotel. We got a pretty nice room. I would say it's, let me do like a little bit of a wide lens. So this is our room. We have, I have to show you guys the outfit for tomorrow. You can see it better there. The sleeves are a little bit annoying. I feel like the two times I have worn it to try it out, I literally spill everything, especially like when I'm doing my makeup. And then these are the shoes that I'm gonna be wearing. And then I'm wearing these fishnets with the jewels. They look so cute. I have already tried out the outfit and I love it. And then this is our bathroom situation. It's kind of dark in here, especially when you don't have this mirror on. It's pretty dark. And then this is my outfit for today. We went to the zoo, we went to the aquarium. I have this, this is like a bodysuit from Target. This is a belt from, I think it's Amazon. I got it years ago, so I don't remember. And then these jeans are American Eagle. And then I have my Adidas shoes, the holographic ones. These are actually size, like kids' shoes. I just bought them a bigger size. And then my cardigan, I got it from Marshall's. I think it's Jessica Simpson's brand. Yeah, my husband went to get Checkers because we haven't had Checkers in so long and we love it. And they don't have it. I don't think they have it in South Carolina, but he went to get Checkers and then I am going to shower. I'm going to do my hair because I like second day better. So I'm going to do it tonight so that tomorrow night it looks, you know, amazing. And I'm probably going to go with the same, like just a blowout and then some curls. I think I'm going to do the curls in the morning as well because I feel like I don't like when they're like super, you know, like up here. I like them like this, like loose. So I will have like the whole day for them to go down a little bit. Anyways, I am going to shower and I will see you guys tomorrow.
Bro, it up?
Yeah. I love this eyeshadow from the Halsey brand. So I'm supposed to be doing that line, the really long one, not this one. This is general admission, and then this is floor. Yo, look at the stage. Okay, I'm on my way to floor. I got my drink. I went to the bathroom. I found one that didn't have a line, so that's good. Now I'm going down to the floor to find my seat.
Take me to the instrumental part, and I'll show you where the right cue is.
Excuse me.
at you. Just look at you. And like, wait, no. Listen. And I'm so sick of them coming at me again. As if I was a man, then I'd be the fake man. I'm so sick of running as fast as I can. Wonder if I'd get there quicker if I was a fake man. And I'm so sick of them coming at me again. As if I was a man, then I'd be the fake man. I'd be the man.
Cheers and Willow, and I missed it because I went to get some alcohol. Oh well, look at it.
Thank you. Joyous, unforgettable time. Don't leave that behind, because it's also incredible being 19 to 24, anywhere in there. But it's just the intensity. It's the intensity of all those peaks and valleys, right? They're just, I feel like there's a lot of middle ground. They're either so sad or so happy. This is just from my experience. This is just what I went through. I'm not projecting on you. But my experience was that I was either so sad or so happy or so heartbroken or so hopeful or so sure or so lost. That's how I experienced the ages that I was when I wrote the Red album. So when I put the album out into the world, it was really cool to feel met in those emotional places. And then a really insanely cool thing happened a couple of years ago. I decided to re-record my first 6 albums. This album out into the world. You have made them so special for me. And so I'd like to sing another song from this album if you happen to have 10 minutes to spare.
So Bye.
this tour is that we, I don't know if you've noticed this, you do have a bracelet on the place.
Yes!
Obviously, we can do really cool patterns and make it look like stars in here. It's just so fun. But it also means I can see absolutely every single person. So if you think that you're in the last row of the top upper section and you think I can't see you, that would be incorrect. I can see you. I see you thrashing around, dancing, jumping, being incredible. Thank you. Thank you for your support, because I see that it's on the level. I pick these songs out of just like little batches of things that I think that I hope you might like. But I wanted to do one that I've never performed live before. I made this decision, you know, after the shows, I cannot go to sleep for a very solid bunch of hours, because I just get so, I just get so excited and wired through the show that going to sleep is something that, it happens like into the morning hours when that happens. So I just like kind of, you know, don't really fight it. And I like plan out what I'm gonna do the next day. And I was trying to figure out what song to do. And then I looked at the clock and it said 3 a.m. and I was like, oh.
Is the love issue. scared to get old. Chasing make-believe status, last time it felt free. Cause none of that shit matters, cause you are with me. But now the word done and it's over, I bet it's hard to believe.
Questions, by the way, I don't want you to think there's any pressure on the questions that I ask. Was there anyone who has seen the show this weekend before tonight? Is there anyone who's seen the show for the first time tonight? So, like, you know, a city, like, tends to either be, like, on fire. Like, they tend to kind of bring that with them through all the shows. Like, Atlanta from the first show, we were just like, you guys are on another new level. This is so hype, it's crazy. So I was like, on our last night, I really want to give them songs that I like a lot. I don't know if you like them a lot, but I'm going to see in a second. But I really like this one, so I was like, I just want to say thank you for the way that you've acted towards us. It's been really great.
Hey guys, it's the next day. I'm a little bit hangover, but not as bad as I thought I would be, so that's good. I wanted to get on here and sit. Let me sit on the toilet because I wanted to get on here and tell you guys about my experience front row. I feel like I don't want to do front row ever again. Like, it was good in the sense that, like, obviously I saw her like 3 feet away from me. You know what I mean? Like, I just...
It was so surreal. I cried. It was just the best. But I feel like when you're on the floor, you don't see anything. All you see is the freaking screen. And honestly, for BTS, I was like in the 300s and I was in the front row, like the first row in the hundreds. So whenever they came around with the card, I was able to see them up close. And I feel like that was even better than like even being like too close to Taylor Swift. You know what I mean? Like, I just feel like the rest of the concert was good, but I couldn't see anything. So yeah, I don't think I'm gonna do floor again. It's just not for me. I knew it wasn't gonna be for me. I didn't pick this seat anyway. Like, if you guys have seen my vlogs, you know how I got it. But I feel like next time I am gonna try to buy one in the hundreds, because I feel like that is the best spot. My husband asked me like if I not regretted it, like, and I told him like if I could go back in time, I would still do the floor because it's still an experience that I wanted. And I now know for a fact that I don't like the floor. Like, before it was like, I don't think I'm gonna like the floor. Like, it was just like assuming. And now that I have the experience in the floor, it's like, yeah, I don't like the floor. So for the next concerts, I'm definitely not gonna be on the floor, but it was definitely amazing. I cannot believe that it happened. I am still like not, like, it's still not processing in my head that I went to see Taylor Swift and I saw her so close. Like, so yeah, that is it for this video. Again, if you guys like reading, I don't know if I said it in the intro, but I do make book videos here on YouTube. So if you guys like reading, make sure you check out the rest of my videos. And yeah, I will see you in my next one.